I am a philosophy professor, but I didn't start out that way. I started out in physics. I got a master's degree in physics before I switched to philosophy. And an education in physics is very rigorous, it's very hard, it's very intense. You would think I would have been, at the end of that, a real expert when it comes to, let's say, logic and argumentation. And in a sense, that's true, logic. But in a sense, it's not. There was something missing. I didn't really understand argumentation, even with a master's degree in physics. It was only when I changed, when I switched to philosophy and I took logic classes, that I really understood the nature of argumentation. Once upon a time, when I was a PhD student in physics, I was in a class in quantum mechanics. And class ended and we walked out of the room, the professor, myself, and a few other graduate students, and another physics professor came in, was walking down the hallway. And the two physics professors started disagreeing with each other. And they like really disagreed. It wasn't like a minor thing. It was like one person was saying this is 100% true and the other person was saying this is 100% false. And they were disagreeing over something called string theory. And this was many years ago because I'm old. And so this is a really interesting case of disagreement because first of all, this is going to happen to you a lot. But what's interesting about it is that here are experts. We've got experts who disagree with each other. That's like feature number one. Feature number two is they're disagreeing about something where they know that there's going to be new and relevant evidence coming in the near future, like over the next 10 years or so. And the other feature, that's the second feature, the third feature that's interesting about this case of disagreement is that these were two people who had shared all their reasons back and forth, and yet they were completely disagreeing with each other. So what are you supposed to do in that type of situation?
The first thing you're going to understand is what the nature of argumentation is. And of course, this is crucial because when it comes to disagreement, how do you handle disagreement? You argue back and forth with the person that you're disagreeing with. And things you're going to learn are good patterns of argumentation and different kinds of good patterns, and also the bad patterns of argumentation, the ones that you want to avoid. And when you do this and you work on it really hard, what will happen is, this is what happened to me anyway, is it's almost like you get a God's eye insight into the nature of your own thinking, what exactly your beliefs are, what your reasoning is, and sometimes most importantly, what your hidden assumptions are.
What we're going to do is have you thinking about various different kinds of disagreement situations that you're going to face as a PhD student. Things having to do with experts, things having to do with sharing your evidence, things of where you're aware that new evidence is going to be coming in, evidence that's relevant to your disagreement but you don't know about yet. And we'll be looking at kinds of disagreement in all different fields, like physics, like biology, like anthropology, English, history, so that you can deal with disagreement in a professional setting, but also just for some hints on how to deal with disagreement in your own personal life.